all this touchy-feely sculling has left you wanting something with a bit more workout in it, well, this week should give you that. Sit Scull works more muscles than we care to mention, if you do it correctly. It's a great way to develop your feel for the water because you must literally connect your hands to the water in order to move forward. Sit Scull also demands that you stay focused or you won't be able to accomplish the key points of the drill. Why do it? Sit Scull is a great way to work out while learning how to use your hands properly. It demands that you connect with the water, and it works not only your forearms, but also your abs. How to do it? Take a look at Kevin Clement's position in the video. A quick way to get into this position is to push off the wall and flip. While we don't show it on the video, a flip is more effective than pushing off in a seated position. The goal of the drill is to hold your knees, feet, and head out of the water, or right at the surface. Your knees should be at a 90-degree angle and the shins parallel to the surface. Your thighs should remain perpendicular to your shins. Holding this crunched position is like performing a long sit-up, as you can see by looking at Kevin's stomach. To support everything, you will have to move your hands back and forth quickly. If you slow down or don't create enough pressure, then your legs or head will sink under the surface. How to do it really well, the fine points. One of the great things about this drill is that you can check how you're doing while you're doing it. With your head high, you'll be able to check the angle of your feet and your ability to maintain a consistent level in the water through the entire length. With the tremendous demonstration that Kevin is doing, watch how stable everything is, except his hands. This is the real connection and real mastery. Look at how nothing else moves other than the effort you see in the sculling action of his hands. As we said last week, even though this isn't translating into a specific spot in any one stroke, it is a move that you'll perform in every stroke. Keep the distances short and the rest interval high when you start this. If you do this right, it's a tough one.